I could really learn to like that.
I guess I'll drill them out and could burn it out.
Needs to be sunk down. That needs to be more like a rim.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering.
You can get the globe that goes in there. Yeah.
What's it done work for?
Pretty good stuff, whatever that is.
Go.
There you go.
I mean, people from up north come down here and they just
melt.
Die. High in a little bit.
Oh, this is
yeah, this is going off now, so that's good.
Do a fiberglass and use the cloth.
Use way more walnuts than it really wants, and I cut them way bigger than they ever would want them, and I. And fly her, it was $200 to fly with me, and it was like $1,500 to fly her home. I thought, well, I'm going.
I'll just take a little trip.
Yeah.
Now that is the $1,000.
Yep.
Can I take one quick look at this?
Yeah, sure.
After.
Yeah.
There
it
is. No.
Coffee's good.
We haven't cooked
that's
anything
fine.
Yet.
We'll put one more layer on it.
He's...
I think this is more UV damage.
Goes down.
You think?
Yeah.
That's probably sick, though.
They've been out there for over a year.
Lord, we got to rebuild this. Well, it was funny. I worked so hard at this and had it sitting there, and then some guy comes in and stepped and broke his foot. And then,
not the way it goes.
And then I saved his foot, but then somebody cleaned and threw the foot away.
Oh, no.
And then it was like, oh, we've got to get this finished.
We'll spend the rest of the day doing this. I don't think we're going to get to paint today at all. Well, the poor dragons haven't even been on the boat yet, and we're doing repairs on them. We made the mistake is that the styro spray is not that great with UV light with only one coating. Now, those pieces didn't have any problems, but they had like five or six coats on it. This we'd only put one on, and we set it aside. Water got into it. The ice did damage underneath, and so... We peeled off a lot of the one layer of spire spray that was there, pulled off a lot of the scales, so we're patching it. We figured out a great patch routine.
Yeah, good girl. So our fix is some of this two-part epoxy clay. I'm learning to really love this stuff because it's kind of fun. You can mold it, and you got this variety. You got like 25 minutes of working time with it. So you can just push it in the way you like it and call it good. And it doesn't look pretty up close, but from, you know, the other boat distance, it'll look good. All we gotta do is kind of make it up to scale shape and stick it on. This is called Styro Spray 1000. You actually buy it from the manufacturer online.
For the slag, you get the slag layer over the weld, so it helps it cool a little slower. The day you see me in a casino is the day Alzheimer's is so totally set in. I'm not casino material.
You're not a donator to the
absolutely
Native American
not.
So Lalani would be gold?
With green, yes.
So we need to get some green.
Yes. Base coat on those, and then I'll come back with
yeah.
The glittery stuff and just shield it and do it that way.
Yeah. Huh. It's traveling down the rollers as it comes. Tinted.
Yeah. Isn't that cool?
God, he looks like a fishing lure.
I know. I love it.
You can go whale fishing with it. That is cool. Purples, huh? Are you bringing out your dragon artistry, Sue?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Definitely. She's wearing her Sea Explorer shirt.
Oh, yeah. Awesome.
Cool, huh?
Yeah.
Me, I'm just wearing this beautiful shirt. This
beautiful seeker
and
shirt.
I happen to have it.
There you go.
In the gift shop, in the junk shop.
You're not running an ad or anything, are you?
No, this I would never do that.
Oh, okay. That would be exploiting.
But I got a compliment at Home Depot for it.
Oh, did you?
Yes, I did.
Awesome.
You know, you could take 3/4 of an inch out. It wouldn't matter.
Okay.
I'm not sure 3/4 inch would be enough. Let's take an inch.
Take an inch off.
Let's see if it's just now.
There's that 100 pounds. About that, we figured.
Shit, man, we just barely got it. We got about halfway there with an inch. Let's take out an inch and a half.
Yeah.
Maybe two. Just a...
Yep. Oh, come on, baby.
Did it good. Yeah, that's acceptable. Thing is, it spreads out further coming this way, so we're not going to be able to get that other pipe on.
Well,
we'll need to pull it in and then weld a piece in there. The ladies are waiting for the paint to dry, but this is what our dragons are coming out to, and they're doing a sweet job. It has a very Chinese vibe to it. Oh, yeah, they're like, oh, this is like a French manicure, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. It's still, you're right, it's
I'm
still wet.
You knew what that was.
Hey, I was married to a very high class woman for a while that spent a lot of money on nails. Well, we're back in the solar tank again because the sun's down that I can bear it in here. And I got some of this stuff. A couple of you recommended it. Flex Seal Yellow. Oh, it's yellow. They also have a, you know, they got some really funky stuff I found. I like this, as seen on TV. It's like, oh, by the way, we spent tens of thousands of dollars on advertising this stuff, and we really would like you to help us make up the cost of that. So, here, buy some. That is nasty. Okay, this is going to need a good squeeze. There we go.
Yeah, that's pretty.
No, I probably ought to have a fan in here with me, but think bad thoughts and those brain cells die, right? Stops leaks fast. Well, we'll see. Well, he's got a smiley face, so it must work. Now, that must be why this pipe's being sold as a second, because it's got a bulge right there on its weld. They just forgot to grind it down.
You know what? I'm not gonna grind it, I'm gonna cut this out. We're gonna taper it, so make sure that ends up in a taper. Yeah, problem solved.
Yeah, it'll work.
These are my favorite. Cubitron 2.
Somebody told me about them, and I just love the things. They cost a lot. I think they're, I don't remember. They're like over 20 bucks a piece. But they last a long time. They cut like they don't gum up. They even work on aluminum well. They awesome disc. You know, I had something awesome happen to me this weekend on YouTube, because I actually read the comments and I comment back most of the time. But there was this, you know, I've had this one so many times. You know, I'm using those, it's either the silica sand or it's the, I think it was the glass microspheres. You know, it's like, and the comment was, those things will shred your lungs, you don't know what you're doing, and it's just too dangerous. And it's like, you know, and I don't remember what I said, it was something along the, you know, warning fear memes are dangerous for getting anything done in your life or something like that. And what was remarkable was that the guy, and I don't know who it was, and he went out and he actually did the research on it, and he comes back and he says, you know, I'm sorry, I'm wrong, and here's the PDF, it's a research paper, and they had exposed these mice to glass microspheres, and sure enough, just like sand and to a large extent silica, you know, the mucus system in the lungs expels this stuff over time. The concentrations in the lungs fall off rapidly. It's not like asbestos that has little needles that, you know, stay in there for life. And, you know, a lot of this stuff is to take it in stride. You know, we're not doing lead work every day, and we don't have small children or women that could get pregnant in here. You know, we take reasonable precautions, but don't go insane. And if you don't know, please, for God's sakes, don't go spreading like Chicken Little all over the internet. Oh, the sky is falling, glass microspheres. It's like that. Figure it out. You know, do the research. Do a little prudence in your judgment. Educate your mind some. And then, you know, most of the time it's like, yeah, it's fine. You get off your ass and go to work. See, this split is flared out. It's wider here, so this is actually too big to go into there, so we're gonna try and pinch it down, get it to fit, and then we'll weld a brace across here on the inside, hold it in that position. That's plan anyway. So it's been going pretty dang good. We're still on plan A, almost. Looks close, very close. Build a really big boat, he said.
Alright.
It's 18 inches long. I put 6 inches into this side. That gives me 12 inches out here. I'm now at 11 inches, so I got 1 inch sticking in. Now, this gap is opened up over here again. So if we weld this plate where that gap can't open up, then this is going to be a real bitch to do. So I think we're going to have to taper, cut these so they taper more like that. We're going to have to squeeze the bejesus out of it to put it together for real. But if that doesn't work, we'll just cut some slots down it and we'll loosen some of the tension off of it that way. So we can make it work afterwards anyway. See, what we're going to do is we're going to weld this coupler into this pipe. This is the bottom. That's the top piece, the mast. We're going to get them hot dip galvanized, which means they can't go to the yard this long. Then we're going to bring them back. We're going to grind off the galvanizing, burn holes through here, slide them together, and weld down into this plate through these holes,
as well then as we'll do this seam, which will be a butt joint then with a backing. It's a lot. It'll work. It'll work. Let's take the pressure off this. See what it does.
Quarter inch gap. And over here it's nice and flush. But over here it hasn't spread out. Now it could be the masts aren't perfectly aligned, and that's part of it. Yeah, they're not lined up perfectly. A little rainwater in the bottom of the tank today. But we got all of that wall done and all the seams done. I think leaks in the seam. I don't think it's in that wall, but that's the side that it was leaking on. So I'll turn the water on, see what happens there. That's cool. You can actually hear it moving in this joint as this well cools and contracts. I used a level to get the two sections of pipe as straight as they could and eyeballed them for the, you know, side to side down there. So now I'm going to tack in this piece into this pipe. We can cut it loose later if it's wrong. Now I'll pull this joint free again. Leaking. And no, I'm not going to try anything else. That's it. We'll just live with a leak. Let's grow some moss out here this summer.